Hi friends, in this video we are solving one of the application of one dimensional heat equation problem. Given problem is a rod of length L with insulated sides is initially at uniform temperature U0. Rod length is L. Suppose if you consider this is a rod. Okay, just you consider this is a rod. Length is L. Length L, insulated sides is initially at uniform temperature U0. Its ends are suddenly cools to 0 degree centigrade and are kept at the temperature. So, temperature are kept at 0 degree centigrade only. Find the temperature of the function U of x comma t. Temperature of the function clearly they are mentioned. So, is it a wave equation or heat equation? Clearly, heat equation only. So, the temperature of this problem is belongs to heat equation only. So, the temperature function U of x comma t, which satisfies the given differential, which satisfies the heat equation. Okay, the heat equation you consider as dou U by dou t is equal to C square into dou square u by dou x square. Dou square u by dou x square. You see, length here, x is equal to 0 and x is equal to L. Length. Right. Now, here u is the function of both x and t. Both x and t. Now, we have to solve this one. This solution of the one-dimensional heat equation we are discussed in earlier. Do you remember that generally? If you don't know also, just you have to remember the solution of one dimensional heat flow equation is U of x comma t is equal to C1 cos px plus C2 sin px into C3 into e to the power of minus C square p square t. Friends, you remember? This is the solution of one-dimensional heat flow equation. One-dimensional heat flow equation. This equation will satisfy dou U by dou T is equal to C square into dou square U by dou X square. Right. Every time they won't give. Just you need to remember this one-dimensional heat flow equation as well as solution also you have to remember. See here, C3 is outside. You can multiply C3 inside. Then what will happen means C1, C3 I am considering as a capital C1. Cos px plus C2, C3 also I am considering as a C2. Sin px into e to the power of minus C square p square t. So, the solution we need to find this. Now, how many arbitrary constants are there here? Two arbitrary constants. What are those? C1 and C2. Now, we have to solve this C1 and C2 values by using the given information. In the given information, actually, we are finding what? U of x comma t. U of x comma t. Observe, the given conditions are what? A rod length is L. Insulated side initially at uniform temperature is U0. Initially at a uniform temperature is U0. So, at the what you can say means U of x comma 0. Initially means at a time t is equal to 0, the temperature is how much? U0. Initially at uniform temperature is U0. So, at T is equal to 0, uniform temperature U is what? U0. That is only I wrote here. Right. Next, another condition what they gave here. You see, at the ends are suddenly cooled to 0 degree centigrade and kept at the temperature, fixed temperature. Okay. Now, actually U of x comma T. Ends are what here? X is equal to 0 and x is equal to L. So, U of x is equal to 0 means 0 comma t is how much they are kept at a how many degrees centigrade? 0 degrees. Okay. 0 degrees centigrade. So, this is 0 degrees centigrade. And one more end is also there. What is that here? X is equal to L. So, L comma t. This is also how much? 0. Now, you observe x is moved from 0 to L. So, these conditions are called boundary conditions. Boundary condition. And this condition is called a initial condition because they are discussed t at one point only. But here they are discussed x at different points. That is why it is called a boundary conditions. Now we have to use these all conditions and we have to find the C1 and C2 values, then you will get the final solution of this problem. Okay, anyway, now this is you consider as the given differential equation, you consider as means heat equation flow is 1 and we need to find the solution for this, this as 2. Now by using the condition, what I have means here, you see these boundary conditions I am using. First, x is equal to what? 0. H, x is equal to 0. Equation 2 implies, you see, u of x comma t value is how much at x is equal to 0? 0 is equal to C1 cos 0 is how much? 1 plus C2 sin 0 is how much? 0 into this is, see, here also you can apply. Okay, so capital C1, capital C2, just you consider. E to the power of t, are they given? No, they are not given anything. C square, e to the power of minus c square p square t. Now you observe, if you simplify this, c1 into 1 is c1, e to the power of minus c square p square t is equal to left side or right side, what I have? 0, that I am writing left side. Now product of two functions are 0. Now you observe, is exponential function anywhere 0? At t is infinite only it is 0. E power minus infinity is 0. But are we discussing t at the infinite point? No. Okay, now. So in this case, what you will get here from this equation? C1 is equal to 0. C1 is equal to 0. Next, if C1 is equal to 0, then this equation will become u of x comma t is equal to C2 sin px into e to the power of minus c square p square t. Now, you used only one condition. Another boundary condition, what you have? At x is equal to L. At x is equal to L, u of x comma t is 0. At x is equal to L, now we are discussing. Previously, we discussed at x is equal to 0. Now, at x is equal to L. Equation 2, nothing but this equation. Okay, this is you consider as 2. Now, this equation 2 implies, C1 already 0 now. So, left side, what I have here? This is x is equal to L, what do you have? 0. 0 is equal to, right side, C1, 0. Next, C2 is C2 sin p into, in place of x, what I have to substitute? L. So, sin pl into e to the power of minus c square p square t. Obviously, this e to the power of minus c square p square t is not equal to 0. Which is 0? Sin pl is 0 or C2 is 0? If C2 is also 0, suppose, if C2 is also 0, then you observe C1 cos px plus C2 sin px is nothing but x is 0 or not. If x is 0, u is what here? 0. So, that is trivial solution. We are not taking the trivial solution here in this case. So, C2 is not equal to 0. If C2 not equal to 0, the remaining term what I have? Sin pl. So, sin pl is equal to 0, which implies you can write pl sin pl as sin n pi. So, pl is equal to n pi. So p is equal to n pi by l. P is equal to n pi. Friends, here if we put p is equal to n pi by l in u of x comma t, then u of x comma t is equal to c2 sine px will become n pi x by l. E to the power of minus c square t into p square. What is the p square? N square pi square by l square. Okay, now you observe this c square. This C2 I am replacing with replacing C2 by BN. C2 by BN. Why I am replacing means to get the most general solution is obtained by adding all the solutions for n is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on. Then in this case, u of x comma t is equal to summation n is equal to 1 to infinite BN sine n pi x by l e to the power of minus c square n square pi square t by l square. Okay, now you observe one more bn is also there here. Now we have another condition. Third condition is we have. What is the third condition means? Initial condition. That initial condition is u of x comma 0 is equal to u naught. So then from this what I can get means we have this, if you put t is equal to 0, this is u naught is equal to summation n is equal to 1 to infinite bn sin n pi x by l into e to the power of 0. This t is then, t is in the power of e. So e power 0 will become 1. So 1 into this is as it is. Again you have bn is unknown. How to find this bn? Which formula we have means? Are they given any condition, another condition means? No. We already used 2 boundary conditions and 1 initial condition also we used. But here only you have to observe. So this is sine function. So to solve the trigonometric functions like this type of the problems, we have Fourier series. 2 types of the Fourier series we have. One is Fourier sine series, another one is Fourier cosine series we have. But here you have sine function only. So to get the u0 value, we have to use off-range sine series. Why off-range sine series? Why not Fourier sine series? Means here they given x is from 0 to L only, not from 0 to 2L. If 0 to L, then we have to use off-range sine series. Now for the off-range sine series, Bn is equal to, you have 2 by L times of integral 0 to L f of x. What is the f of x means here? Just u, f of x is what I have? U naught into sine n pi x by L. So now you have to do into dx. Now we have to do solution for this, integration for this. 2 by L is a constant, u naught is also constant. Now integral 0 to L sine n pi x by L into dx. Now sine integration is, this is 2 u naught by L sine integration minus cos n pi x by L divided by n pi by L. Okay, limits from 0 to L. Now we have to apply 0 to L. See here, these are getting cancelled. LL getting cancelled. Now you have 2 u naught by n pi. Minus is also I am writing outside. Then cos n pi. X means L. L by L is cancelled. Then you will have cos n pi minus lower limit you substitute. This minus is I wrote here. Remember. So cos 0 is what? 1. Okay now. Now cos n pi. You will have like cos n pi is sometimes plus 1, sometimes minus 1 also. So when you will get plus 1, minus 1 means if n is even, then you will have plus 1. If n is odd, then you will have minus 1. If n is even case, so you will have 2 cases now. Minus 2 u naught by n pi here into, you have 0 if n is even case. Okay now. Next, here you will have cos n pi is minus 1. Sorry, cos n pi is minus 1 for odd. N odd. Then in this case, minus 1 means minus 2. In this case, 0. So you can also write this as 0 into 2 u naught by n pi is 0. That is 0 when it is, when n is even. Next, 2 times of 2 u naught by n pi. 2 times of 2 means 4. Minus of minus is plus. So 4 u naught by n pi. This is when n is odd case. Okay now. Hence, here you see, you have bn value now. Now we have to substitute bn value in u of x comma t. So u of x comma t is equal to, here you see, we have generally summation n is equal to 1 to infinity. I am writing the previously what I have, bn sine n pi x by L into e to the power of minus c square pi square n square by L into t. Now I am replacing bn value here. Okay now, then I will get 4 u naught by n pi, 4 u naught by n pi summation. This is for odd numbers, you remember, for odd numbers. So I am writing like 2n plus 1. Okay, 2n plus 1, 2n minus 1 also you can add. For odd now, n if it is 1, then it will become 2 minus 1 is 1. So 2n minus 1 you can add. Sine of 2n minus 1 to infinity. Okay, this is, you have 1 by 4n pi, 4 I written outside, n is inside I have read because n is a natural number now. So 4 u naught by pi, 1 by n times of sine of n pi x by L times of e to the power of minus c square n square pi square t by L. That's it. Also you can write this as, just replace this 2n minus 1 now. So if you want to write n is equal to 1 to n, n replaced by 2k minus 1, or simply 2n minus 1 also you can write. 4 times of u naught by pi into summation n is equal to 1 to infinite. Just n replaced by 2n minus 1. 2n minus 1 times of sine of 2n minus 1 pi x by l into e to the power of minus c square pi square. N is 2n minus 1 whole square t by l. So this is what value? The temperature function for the given problem. Okay now, friends, I am repeating again how to solve this problem.